Today's lesson is equations of a parabola with vertex at point hk. Learn how to derive the following equations. Number 1, quantity x minus h squared is equal to 4p times the quantity y minus k. Number 2, quantity y minus k squared is equal to 4p times the quantity x minus h. The derivation of the equation quantity x minus h squared is equal to 4p times the quantity y minus k, where p is greater than 0. Let us look at this figure. This is the y-axis. This is the x-axis. This is a parabola opening upward with vertex at point hk. The vertex is h units away from the y-axis and k units away from the x-axis. This is the directrix. The equation of the directrix is y is equal to k minus p. Point A is a point on the directrix. The coordinates of the points are x and k minus p. This is the axis of symmetry. The equation of the axis of symmetry is x is equal to h. The directrix is p units away from the vertex. The focus is also p units away from the vertex. Point P with coordinates x to y is a point on the parabola. It represents every point on the parabola. According to the definition of parabola, every point on the parabola is equidistant from the focus and the directrix. Based on that definition, PF is equal to PA. Using the distance formula, the square root of the quantity x minus h squared plus the quantity y minus open parenthesis k plus p close parenthesis and then squared is equal to the square root of the quantity x minus x squared plus the quantity y minus open parenthesis k minus p close parenthesis and then squared. Squaring both sides, we have the quantity x minus h squared plus the quantity y minus open parenthesis k plus p close parenthesis and then squared is equal to the quantity x minus x close parenthesis squared plus the quantity y minus open parenthesis k minus p and then squared. Now this is equal to the quantity x minus h squared plus the quantity y minus k minus p squared. This is preceded by a minus sign, so k now is negative and positive p is now negative. Now this is equal to, this becomes 0, y minus k plus p squared. This is preceded by a minus sign, so k is now negative and negative p is now positive p. Square x minus h, square y minus k minus p, square y minus k plus p. Square the first term, multiply the first term by the second times 2, and then square the second term. Let's do that. X squared minus 2xh plus h squared. Square the first term, square the second term, square the third term. And then after that, multiply the first term by the second times 2. Multiply the first term by the third term times 2. Multiply the second term by the third term times 2. Let's do that. Positive y squared plus k squared plus p squared minus 2yk minus 2yp plus 2kp is equal to square the first term, square the second term, square the third term. After that, multiply the first term by the second times 2, multiply the first term by the third term times 2, multiply the second by the third term times 2. Let's do that. Y squared plus k squared plus p squared minus 2yk plus 2yp minus 2kp. And then, cancel y squared and y squared, because when you transpose this to the other side, it becomes negative. And when you combine it with 2y squared, the result is 0. And then cancel k squared and k squared. When you transpose this to the other side, it becomes negative. And when you combine it with this, the result is 0 also. Cancel positive p squared and positive p squared. When you transpose this to the other side, it becomes negative p squared, and when you combine it with positive p squared, the result is 0. Cancel negative 2yk and negative 2yk, because when you transpose this to the other side, it becomes positive 2yk, and combining it with the negative 2yk, the answer is 0. So we have now x squared is minus 2xh plus h squared is equal to 2yp minus 2kp plus 2yp minus 2kp. This is this one. And then when you transpose this to the other side, it becomes positive, this one negative. Combine the terms that are similar. This one is similar to this. This is similar to this. You combine them. We have now x squared minus 2xh plus h squared is equal to 4yp minus 4kp. This is a perfect square trinomial with factors x minus h and x minus h. Now, this can be written as the quantity x minus h squared. So, we have now the quantity x minus h squared. Let us factor this. There is a common factor for then p. So, the common factor is 4p. Let us factor 4p out. So we have now 4p times the quantity y minus k. So we have the quantity x minus h squared is equal to 4p times the quantity y minus k. The derivation of the equation quantity y minus k squared is equal to 4p times the quantity x minus h, where p is greater than 0. Let us look at this figure. This is the y-axis. This is the x-axis. This is a parabola opening to the right with the vertex at point h, k. This is the focus of the parabola with the coordinates h plus p and k. This is the directrix. The equation of the directrix is x is equal to h minus p. Point A is a point on the directrix. The coordinates of point A are h minus p and y. This is the axis of symmetry. The equation of the axis of symmetry is y is equal to k. The directrix is the p units away from the vertex, and the focus is also p units away from the vertex. point P with coordinates the x, y is a point on the parabola. It represents every point on the parabola. According to the definition of parabola, every point on the parabola is equidistant from the focus and the directrix. Based on that definition, PF is equal to PA. Using a distance formula, the square root of the quantity x minus open parenthesis h plus p close parenthesis and then squared plus the quantity y minus k squared is equal to the square root of the quantity x minus open parenthesis h minus p close parenthesis and then squared plus the quantity y minus y squared. Squaring both sides, we have the quantity x minus open parenthesis h plus p close parenthesis and then squared plus the quantity y minus k squared is equal to the quantity x minus open parenthesis h minus p close parenthesis and then squared plus the quantity y minus y squared. So this is now equal to the quantity x minus h minus p squared. This becomes the negative h, this becomes negative p, plus y minus k squared is equal to x minus h plus p squared. This is preceded by a minus sign, so this becomes negative h, this becomes positive p, this becomes 0. Square x minus h minus p, square y minus k, square x minus h plus p. X squared plus h squared plus p squared minus 2xh minus 2xp plus 2hp. And then square the first term, multiply the first term by the second times 2, square the second term. Let's do that. Plus y squared minus 2yk plus k squared. Next, square the first term, square the second term, square the third term. After that, multiply the first term by the second times 2, multiply the first term by the third times 2, multiply the second by the third times 2. Let's do that. X squared plus h squared plus p squared minus 2xh plus 2xp minus 2hp. Then cancel x squared with x squared, because when you transpose this to the other side, it becomes negative. And when you combine it with x squared, the result is 0. And then cancel h squared with h squared, because when you transpose this to the other side, it becomes negative. And when you combine it with the positive h squared, the result is 0. Cancel positive p squared with positive p squared, because when you transpose this to the other side, it becomes negative, and combining it with this, the result is 0. Cancel also negative 2xh and negative 2xh, because when you transpose this to the other side, it becomes positive. If you combine it with this, the result is 0. So we have now y squared minus 2yk plus k squared is equal to 2xp minus 2hp plus 2xp minus 2hp. This becomes the positive on the other side, and then this one, negative on the other side. Combine the terms that are similar. These are similar, so combine them. This and this one are similar. Let's combine them. So we have now y squared minus 2yk plus k squared is equal to 4xp minus 4hp. This is a perfect square trinomial. Let us factor it. The factors are y minus k and y minus k. This can be written as the quantity y minus k squared. So we have the quantity y minus k squared is equal to, let us factor this. There is a common factor for pp. So the common factor is 4p. Let us factor 4p out. So we have now 4p times the quantity x minus h. So we have the quantity y minus k squared is equal to 4p times the quantity x minus h.